Haikyuu is a sports show done perfectly. Not done well, done perfectly. It's got fun characters, perfect pacing, amazing character development. Everything about this show is awesome. But nothing in Haikyuu is better than our two main characters, Hinata and Kageyama, and their relationship. Individually, they're both incredibly compelling, but together, they create a dynamic that is really the highlight of the anime. Well, that and the meat dance. Anyway, let's get into it, and let's start by talking about our main character, Hinata. We're introduced to him as a super sympathetic, relatable character.
You better not get all cocky, because soon as my tummy stops being upset, I'm gonna wipe the floor with you jerks out there! Do you hear me?
The poor guy has cramps, and nerves, and he's short! Everyone loves an underdog story, and Hinata is the true definition of an underdog. But he never once complains about any of that, at least in the beginning. He's bright-eyed, he's optimistic, regardless of his disadvantages. On top of that, Hinata works incredibly hard. His middle school volleyball team had no infrastructure, so he played with the women instead. Some teenage boys would never train with girls. Not Hinata. He just wants to get better, no matter how it happens. He's always asking his friends to give him a toss, and he does so cheerfully and happily. And even though he works harder than anyone on his team, he's not ungrateful. He's just happy they showed up. Why do we root for Hinata? We do it because he's just so damn likable. His athleticism and prowess, in spite of being unrefined, is basically a promise that one day, he'll find a way to use that raw talent and become incredible. And because he's so friendly and humble and optimistic and relatable, we want more than anything for Hinata to get there. He's just a humble middle blocker, trying to get better at the game. Hinata's so hungry that he shows up at a training camp that he wasn't invited to in the hopes that he can learn something. Is this super cringe? Absolutely. We're all Suki in this moment. But there's something endearing about just how much Hinata wants this. And somehow, he actually does learn something at the camp. He learns to read the game, and he uses that knowledge to perform some awesome receives at Nationals. And then we have Kageyama. In many ways, Kageyama is the opposite of Hinata. Hinata is an unrefined tool, but Kageyama is a prodigy. Hinata is always smiling and makes friends easily, and Kageyama looks like Yuno from Black Clover's grumpy little brother, or what Sasuke would look like if someone told him how stupid this outfit is. Put on a real shirt, you slut! Your outfit's worse than Mei Shiranui's. So, why do we like this moody, pouty, unrelatably talented teenager? Well, for one, he tells people off when they deserve it. In episode 1, some of his teammates make fun of Hinata in the bathroom, but instead of joining in and being cocky, Kageyama berates them for riding on the coattails of their school's reputation. And when Hinata says he's going to win, Kageyama doesn't laugh or anything. He treats Hinata with respect. And when he sees Hinata jump, it's love at first sight. Does Hinata have any chance in this first middle school volleyball match? Of course not. But that doesn't matter. Kageyama demands 100% from his teammates anyway. In real life, this would have been super annoying. We've all been in those group projects full of hardos that ask for too much. But in fiction, it's awesome to have a character care about something as much as Kageyama cares about volleyball. Furthermore, although Kageyama has high expectations, he's also surprisingly humble. Now, this isn't true of every prodigy. Ushijima, for example, is absolutely certain that he's going to crush every opponent in front of him. Karasuno versus Shiratorizawa is the crows versus the eagle, but for Ushijima, it might as well be the eagle versus some ants. Oikawa, Kageyama, Hinata, nobody is a threat to him in his mind. Meanwhile, Kageyama doesn't underestimate anyone, ever. In the very first match, he berates his teammates for slacking off when Hinata grabs a point. Later, once he joins Karasuno, he asks Sugawara for advice, even though Suga, bless his heart, is the far inferior setter. He's always asking people how his toss is and striving to improve. And that humility turns out to be an incredibly valuable weapon. Suga teaches him hand signs, and Oikawa teaches him about how to be a better setter. Without them, he wouldn't have progressed at nearly the same rate that he did. Okay, so we've talked about Hinata, and we've talked about Kageyama. Let's talk about their dynamic. I've already talked about how they're opposites. Tall and short, friendly and surly, a prodigy and an underdog. But in addition to being opposites, Kageyama and Hinata need each other. They obviously need to get along for the sake of the team. This is why Daichi puts them on the same team and forces them to work together, because if they don't get along, morale is going to suffer and they need everyone playing their best. But beyond that, in Season 1, each of their flaws are solved by the other. Hinata doesn't need to be a super skilled spiker if Kageyama can get him perfect tosses every time. Instead, he can just rely on his athleticism. Kageyama doesn't need to adapt to his teammates if he has a weapon like Hinata willing to just blindly trust him. Individually, in middle school, they were both losers. For Hinata, it was due to his talent, and Kageyama, because of his personality. But together, even though they don't like each other, they can win. And win is exactly what they do. They win in the 3-on-3 that lets them join the team, they win against Seijo in their practice match, and with the help of their teammates, they keep winning.
Don't you know who I am?
Karasuno,
bitch!
With all of that said, the biggest and simplest reason they're made for each other is that they both freaking love volleyball. They love volleyball more than Bokuto loves hair gel, and more than Tsukishima loves complaining. Their singular obsession is to win and stay on the court, and keep playing. Honestly, they're both kind of annoying about it. Kageyama doesn't yell at his teammates anymore, but his incessant questioning gets on people's nerves too. Hinata showing up at the training camp is super, super cringe. These two are shameless in how much they love the sport and how much they want to improve, in a way that's super entertaining and endearing for the viewer. And through that love, through that obsession with staying on the court, they're willing to move past their personal obstacles in the pursuit of victory. Kageyama says at the beginning that he'd prefer to set, spike, and block all by himself. By season 4, he's not only giving Hinata what he wants, but giving him advice on how to jump higher based on what he saw from Hoshiyumi.
Oi! Omae, motto toberu zo.
Meanwhile, Hinata starts out nervous as hell, but Kageyama helps him overcome those nerves in his own way after Hinata hits the ball into the back of his head. And remember how I said each of their flaws are solved by the other? This is only true in season 1. But the plotting of this show is so excellent that it links their character arcs together and forces them to grow together instead of apart. Hinata understandably doesn't want to just be a weapon for Kageyama to use. He wants to be his own player, a well-rounded and powerful player in his own right. And once he does, he starts having opinions, like asking Kageyama to give him tosses that he can see and react to. Kageyama is hesitant because it means relinquishing some of his authority and power to someone else. And not only someone else, but the least experienced player on the team. So as Hinata grows, Kageyama is forced to grow alongside him. He even asks Oikawa for advice, and Oikawa tells him to give Hinata the tosses he wants. The result is spectacular, as Hinata is able to make decisions on the fly, thanks to a curving toss that seems to stop in midair. Thanks to Kageyama's new toss, Hinata can develop his skill while he's airborne. And thanks to Hinata demanding more from Kageyama, he gains not only the new toss, but also new insight on teamwork and being a setter, from Oikawa of all people. These two push each other constantly. They race wherever they go, they compete over their vertical jump height, It's like Naruto and Sasuke all over again. And then, Kageyama gets invited to the All Japan training camp. Hinata is obviously jealous, especially when Kageyama says, "I'm going on ahead." Not only was Hinata not All Japan, he wasn't even All County, as Tsukishima is invited to a camp run by Shiro Torizawa's coach. And so, to avoid getting left behind, Hinata attends the camp as a ball boy and learns to read the game. This pays off later in Season 4, as he receives a number of balls from top-tier spikers and is finally becoming a well-rounded player. He even manages to block Ushijima, who is arguably the best player in the series. Haikyuu does an incredible job both pulling these two together and pushing them apart. We have scenes rife with conflict and tension, when they're arguing about the toss, or in the beginning when they're trying to get into the club, when they're separated at their respective training camps. But Kageyama and Hinata also work together, not just on the court, but off of it as well. Kageyama has the opportunity to talk shit about Hinata multiple times, but he only ever calls him strong. They confront Ushijima together, they ride to Tokyo training camp together, they pass their exams together. In the walls of their practice facility, they're at each other's throats, but when it comes to their opponents, they're always united. And the best part is that it all feels natural. Their conflicts all stem from Hinata's hunger to get better and Kageyama's belief that he can do it by himself, and their united front comes from their love of volleyball and focus on victory no matter who the opponent is. I never once felt like anything was forced or out of character with them, and with 4 seasons of anime, that's a seriously impressive feat. The rivalry between Hinata and Kageyama is one of the best I've ever seen out of a television series. It's set up beautifully and somehow only gets better over time, and I can't wait to see how the rest of Nationals unfolds. Speaking of, please God, let the movie or season 5 or whatever's happening with the rest of Haikyuu work out and make sense. If we get another Promised Neverland, then someone needs to be arrested. Anyway, if you like this video, please consider subscribing. I make avatar and anime videos twice a week. Let me know what your favorite KageHina moment is or what anime character or relationship you want me to analyze next. And yeah, until next time.